Actually, I'm trying to find something.
Oh, go do the other
thing. Sorry. Don't have me on doing all that.
My bad.
What was your immediate reaction? Okay, first of all, I want to know, how did you find out their name were changed?
I'm not finding out. I think Libby told me.
Yeah, I probably did.
Libby told me that they had changed their name from Bessie to Khalisa.
still can't get my name right. Khalisa.
Khalisa. And Venetia to Kayla. But then they still have the
original name.
Original name, yeah. Mm-hmm. But when I seen that birth certificate,
did you cry?
No, I did not cry.
Oh.
You was angry?
Yeah, I was mad.
Why you was mad?
Because they had their name on your birth certificate as you guys' parents.
Because yeah. Legally they were our parents.
Yeah.
So I had to accept it. Yeah. I had to accept it.
Did you say something to Miss Martha about it?
I didn't say nothing to him.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Did Lisa ever tell you the story about the time she hid Miss Martha keys to come see you?
No.
She was talking about it today. She told me she asked my second part in the story.
You remember when we used to live over there off Savannah Street? And you
in the Heights.
You was in the halfway house right
yeah,
there.
Yeah.
And we used to come see when you had Tavia as a baby. So one day going to school, I hid my grandma's keys and told her, basically I was trying to walk to school because I wanted to stop at the halfway house to see you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I don't think I ever stopped. I think I walked back.
You didn't get where you walked to school?
I walked to school that day.
Yeah, we did walk to school.
When I came home, I did. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember you guys just come see me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm glad to see you guys. I couldn't wait to Saturday to come with you.
How did you feel when you found out they were moving from?
I felt I was mad, but then Martha told me that me and Tyler could come go.
Why didn't you? Because
I was in my addiction.
Because she.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I was in my addiction. That's
why. Now, if you wasn't.
They wouldn't have been adopted out if I wasn't in my addiction.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to say, them being adopted is actually a blessing.
That's a blessing. Yeah. It is.
It's definitely a blessing.
Because they did more for them what I could do to them for myself.
Absolutely. Not just that. You know, it's one thing we were discussing today, because we went out there, and you know, Martha and what's Papa's real name?
Charles,
those are their legal parents.
Right.
Legally. So right. Anything that they own, they're legally.
Right.
Because I went in the trunk and I was trying to clean everything out the trunk and I opened his bag and I was like, why is my ring here? I could have just been wearing it. So I fucked it up. Close to me again in front of your mama.
But she found it before he could do it.
Where is it at? I didn't see it.
It's at the hotel.
It's
actually
put it back in my bag.
Instead of putting
it
on, you put it back in the bag?
I was thinking he was going to propose again.
Can you go to the mirror? Listen. Can you go to the mirror in the bathroom and slap the first person you see?
Bye.
I said, I'm leaving.
I'm going back to Idaho.
Give me hugs.
To my home.
Give me hugs.
I'm going back home.
Yeah, he's
gonna
be on YouTube.
I love you so much.
This is Facebook Live. This is Facebook Live.
Bye, brother.
Come back with nothing. I'm going crazy. So I can understand. You know the frustration that he had with the women.
He's doing it more than the business.
He's doing more than the business.
It's an example.
Right. So now he said, but it was not right. I can understand why he was so angry. But they brought their money home. They paid the position. Is this what you're doing? If this is your job, then you got to make sure you pay accordingly. You feel what I'm saying? If that's what you're doing, you make sure you come home with what you're supposed to come home with.
Yeah.
My mom didn't do that because she was doing her money. She take her money and go get drugs instead of bringing it back.
Yeah.
For the babies and the kids and the bills. And that was frustrating, so that made her get in trouble more than the other ones.
Yeah.
So when my dad died, I hated him. You understand what I'm saying? You ask these kids, my brother, I hated that man. So I was like, hey, no, he's an evil, mean, devil type guy.
Yeah.
But I did see nice stuff. You know, he took us fishing. Yeah. There was other women, not the ones that were. Yeah. But I seen him be nice to other women. He would cook for them. He would go cater to them. He would dress up. I seen him be like two different people.
Yeah.
Like, we got the kids. Like, he could be mean to them and be a mom. And go be sweet over here.
Yeah.
I'm like, wow. Like, you know what I'm saying? I never understood that. So I was angry. Like, how could you treat them like this and treat my mama like this?
Absolutely.
You feel me? So absolutely. It was just like, it was crazy because I understand as a child.
And it's crazy because I say, even you saying that, because when I talked to her, I was like, bro, your dad, the way you tell me your dad used to beat your mom, how can you, like, love him so much? You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, but now it's here, you talk, like, say, it's night and day. She didn't see him, but you saw. Right. The only thing she saw was a good father every single day.
Right.
So,
right.
So even though it was happening, she didn't see it happening
right.
that way.
Right, right.
So I'm like,
I would ask my dad, I'd be like, can we go outside, can we go to the park? No, go in the room. But we had to stay in the house. So imagine us hearing the screaming, the kind of, they crawling, trying to crawl out the door and crawl out the house and get tossed out the window and crazy. You hear me, bro? He was sticks, iron, belts, whatever.
Yeah.
He'll throw a table on her. Wow. He'll take the whole table and just throw it on her.
That's crazy.
Blood everywhere. It's like a crime scene.
That's crazy.
Get up and go in the room. Ain't nobody going to the hospital. You in the room because you drunk. You have out, you own drugs, you done got whooped, now you gotta go in there and lay down and heal yourself and, you know, y'all clean up and go cook.
That's crazy.
That is crazy. That's crazy.
I'm not having none of that. I don't wanna be nothing like him. I don't wanna be nothing like her. And I'm not accepting what y'all accepted. So, you know what I'm saying? That's something that I did not tolerate.
I expect my kids, I'm gonna try to leave.
Let me stop you. Look, I'm gonna tell you this one story I remember when you said that, right?
Okay.
I remember one time, you remember the story like Ike and Tina, when Tina drinking tea on the bus? Mm-hmm. I had a scene like
girl, get your ass off me.
Like, my mom tried to get away one time. That's the only time I remember her ever trying to get away. Now, I don't know if she ever tried to get away before that or after that, but that brought time I remember. It was me and my brother, right? So we trying to go get on the bus. Like, he must have told her something, so he behind us, so he snatches and she's still going. So she's like, you know, he's right here screaming.
Like, get my kids, nobody's following, nobody's doing nothing. We got on the bed and she came on back and it was, no, I didn't come back that day. I wouldn't go to the motel, me and Colton, he just took me. Yeah, I see, I don't even remember that part. I just remember him coming. So do you feel like you would have had a better life if your father was in the house? I can say that because
I think that all the experience and all the things that I went through, life made me who I am.
Exactly.
To say I have a better life, it would be different.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay, I get it. Absolutely. But I know that I
took what I went through and I didn't let it destroy me. You feel what I'm saying? I let it build me. So I can't say, like, it would have been better. Even if she was the mother that I wanted to be, I can't say that my life would have been better.
Absolutely.
You see what I'm saying? Because I had a lot of people that influenced me in a lot of ways that I didn't have.
Oh, I've seen your hands. Shut up.
So, I just take it for what it is and, you know what I'm saying, and just keep moving forward. I just know that I'm happy who I am.
Yeah.
I love where I come from. I don't like where, you know, where I'm at.
Yeah.
But I understand where I come from. And I understand who I am. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
This is what it is. I can't accept the way of me. I know why I do certain things. That's where I come from. I know how I am. I know how I see where I come from. I could just try to be better. That's my goal, is to be better, try to change the cycle. That's my goal. Now, I do have to kill. Like, you feel like you want to kill him to get away? Or kill him to get your kids? No.